going on, everybody? My name is Daniel Funaki, better known as Funaki, 36 years old. I'm a photographer here based out of Los Angeles. Originally here from East Los Angeles, California. I went to school at Cal State University Northridge, class of 98. I began doing photography in 1993 with a small camera, actually this camera right here, that I got from my mom laying around the house. I took it and I just started taking pictures with my friends. Eventually I moved up to a camera like this. This isn't the original camera, but it's the exact same model. Canon A1 goes with me all over the place. And it's kind of what started the journey of doing street photography. This year it'll be 18 years doing this type of work. When I'm doing photography, I use various different types of cameras because each camera that I use has its own job and its own function. Over the years, my favorite camera, the one that goes with me to every single shoot, is this one right here. This is a 1976 Canon A1. It's a film camera, not digital. As you can see, I use a few different lenses to go with it. And it's probably been the camera that I've taken some of my more well-known pictures over the years. Another camera that I use that's been a favorite of mine over the years is this bad boy, the Big Daddy, the Pentax 6-7. As over the years, as you get bigger jobs and bigger clients, and you show up with a camera like this, you kind of get that respect. Because they know that you mean business. It's a difficult camera to use. It's a huge camera, so you really gotta know what you're doing when you use something like this. It's a medium format film, Pentax 6x7. It goes with me to all the major shoots that I do. Another camera that I use that's been a favorite of mine, especially during my street photography, is it might look like just a really basic camera, but it takes some of the most sharpest and amazing pictures, is the Leica Mini Lux. Probably one of the higher end point and shoot cameras that came out of the early 90s. Whenever I kind of need to be discreet, or I need to be quick, where I'm doing photos and I need to shoot something discreet, this is the bad boy I use. With this type of photography, it's not something that you do to become rich or to have fame and fortune. This is something that has to come in from the heart. You need to do this type of work from the heart. And it's a struggle, photography is a struggle. There's no such thing as there's people banging on my door telling me, hey man, you gotta take my picture. I have to go out there and hustle my way into convincing people that out of the thousands of photographers, guys and girls that are out there, that I'm the one that they have to pick because of the work that I do and the consistency that I do. And I try to treat everybody, all my clients, with that utmost respect and professionalism that they deserve. So it's been a struggle. It's been a journey of 18 years consistently getting out there and putting your name on. One of the favorite places that I love to shoot is outside. One of the things that I've never felt comfortable in is in a studio setting. I've always felt comfortable being outside in the streets, being outside with the people, being outside with, I guess you would call it the working man, the working people, the commoners. That's where I enjoy shooting. So I consider this city my studio. Been shooting down here for so long, I feel comfortable down here, picking different locations, and as long as I've been down here, you always find a new place, a new location to shoot. So the city has been my favorite place to be to shoot. The core of my work has always been working with independent artists. That's been I love working with, but at times the opportunity has arisen where I'm able to work with people who are a little bit more high profile. people who are kind of getting out there into, you know, kind of like they're on the verge of kind of breaking into it, into, you know, not necessarily mainstream, but breaking into a more wider audience and getting out of the United States. Right now I'm working with an amazing record label called Wow Records. You can find them at wowrecords.com. And these guys are seriously no joke when it comes to producing some of the best rock and roll music coming out of LA and Europe. And because of these guys and this label, Wow Records, a lot of my pictures are now circulating in Europe, which is something that I thought would never happen. So it's been definitely a blessing to work with people that are serious about what they do and are taking these images and taking them around the world. But I also do a lot of work with jazz musicians, hip-hop artists, rock and roll, different types of rock and roll that are on that verge of taking it to the next level. Recently I've been doing some work. I did some work with Abnormal Entertainment, hip-hop artist Michael Myers, which is a legend in the underground hip-hop scene here in Los Angeles and around the world. We also did some work with Danny Trejo, better known as Machete. I saw his movie that just came out a while back ago. Just shot Ozumatli, which is right before they went out to perform at Coachella. And probably LA's biggest drug kingpin that came out of the 1980s, Freeway Ricky Ross. We did a pictorial with him. And all using this style of photography, all using the photography that I've been doing for the last 18 years. No special treatment, no special studios, no assistance. It's basically just me and the artist at work in a really low level, low budget setting. For some of you younger guys that are coming up in the photography game, you know, there's no shortcuts in this. It's okay to look at different styles and be inspired by different people and twist it around to your own version of what you like. You know, like there's a famous photographer named Bruce Gilden who said, you know, we all steal, but it's just some of us get caught. So you gotta stay in your own lane and don't take shortcuts, because none of this stuff is an overnight success. It takes hard work, it takes dedication, it takes persistence, and it takes, the work has to come from your heart in order for other people, when other people see it, will be able to feel something for those images. Over the years, I've been inspired by so many different photographers, and I've had the opportunity to meet a few of them in person to kind of get some insight of what has inspired them. But definitely, I've been inspired by Japanese photographer Daito Moriyama, Mexican photographer Graciela Iturbide, LA native and LA legend Esteban Oriol, New York's finest Bruce Gilden, out of Serbia Boogie, Scott Southern, was based out of Los Angeles too, one of the most underrated guys that I've ever met. So many other people that have inspired my work. Roberto Polillo out of Italy, who shot some of the most amazing jazz, live jazz music photography. Jamel Shabazz, who captured some of the most iconic 80s images. Early hip hop, Bruce Davidson, just to name a few. You see a lot of their work, you see in mine. I get a little bit of inspiration, look at their images, and I just try to stir it in a big pot and put my own twist to it, my own version of what I've, what they have inspired me to do, and to do it my own way. I'm Daniel Funaki, and this is My Life in Love.